So let's now combine zeros and poles. So combining zeros and poles. Remember the zeros. What they do is, so we've got this omega zero here, that they are creating a very shallow dip in the frequency response here. So that's our omega, and this was our E2 J omega. So they're creating a damping of omega zero. And so the pole, on the other hand, does the opposite. So if we have here omega, and again we have got omega zero here, E to J omega, so then the pole does, interestingly, just the opposite. So the pole creates a resonance here at this point. Resonance at omega zero. Obviously, both zeros and poles, they're both complex conjugate poles and zeros. So both second order. So the question is now is, obviously, what happens if we combine them? So what's happening then, actually? Okay, so let's do that. So let's write down the full transfer function. So poles and zeros combined and this gives us the following transfer function. So 1 minus 2 cosine omega 0 z to minus 1 plus z to minus 2, because we've got no r here, and then this is 1 minus 2 r cosine omega 0 z to minus 1 plus r square z to minus 2. So this gives us the combined transfer function here. And so the data flow diagram becomes also a bit more complicated with that. So we need to have a summation node at the input, and then we need to have two delay steps. So we know that. And then the one delay step here feeds back to the input here, and we know that this negative sign in this case goes away, so this gives us 2 cosine omega 0 in the multiplication of this pathway here. Then the delayed version here by 2 time steps, this subtracts r square. So in this case we are multiplying this here with minus r square. And so then on the other hand, the output here is calculated by the following time steps. We could use this signal here and have a second delay step here, but we're just recycling the same delays again. So here we have our original signal, undelayed signal here. This is going to the output. Also the 2 time steps delayed signal go straight to the output and is summed up here. So it's our summation at the output, and then we know that this bit in the middle here, this is multiplied by 2 cosine omega 0, but with a negative sign here. Nearly forgotten that, because in this case the negative sign won't go away. And so the other two are just not multiplied, just added up. So that's our output here. So that's our input, and that's our output. And that's our complete filter here. So that's a second order IIR filter. And the question, the interesting question is now, how does this filter behave? Okay, so let's use Python to get an idea how this frequency response looks like. That's obviously the same as always, so that we do an E2 J omega and looking at the absolute value of this and having omega running from 0 to pi to see the frequency response. And so what do we expect? So we expect that if we are running from 2 pi here, that there where there's omega 0, that something is happening here. So we know that the 0 here creates essentially a dip here, which reaching 0 here. So this gives us, this is a numerator response, or the zeros. Then we know that this one generates a resonance at omega 0. So then this one goes like that. So that's generated by the poles or by the denominator. So let's see if we're able to reproduce that in Python. So I've already, so we use for that the inbuilt Python command. So we use frequency Z, and this is using the convention B comma A here. So these are the numerator coefficients, and these are the denominator coefficients here. And so therefore it's very, very simple here. So the A is here. So that's here A of 0. And then together with a minus here, that's A of 1. And then this is here, that's A of 2. And then here we have, that's B of 0, and then this one here, that's B of 1, and this is here just a 1, and that's here B of 2. And so therefore we just need to substitute that into our code here. So I've already done this here when we're looking at the values of A and B. So that's the denominator here. So we've got here the 1, and then the 2, the minus 2 r cosine omega 0, and then the r square here, and then the b coefficient here. So that's the 1 from above here. So that's 1 minus cosine, and then a 1 again. And so that's all good. And then I just generate this frequency response here with the help of this frequency Z command. So that just gives us gets here these coefficients B and A, and then puts this into generalized transfer function and calculates us the result out of that. So what I use here as F0 is 0.1 and an R of 0.9, and let's just see if we are getting a similar response, what I've drawn here. And so that's a case. So here we're getting this nice notch behavior out there, what I've expected here from the superposition of these ones, because that the zero is definitely zero at this point. There's no way around it. Doesn't matter how high this resonance goes, but it will always go to zero here. So we're getting a nice notch response here. So then it's just out of interest. So if I change this here to R 0.99, so this makes the resonance higher. And so if I rerun this here and bring it back up, and we see that this here turns into a nice band stop filter here. So we see here he is going down to his damping. It's a very, very sharp response here, and leaving all the other frequencies intact. And so therefore with that we can create a band stop response, a simple band stop response, just by superimposing this zero and this resonance on top of it.